So after the power pack insights from MF CEOs on MF growth, I mean drivers of the growth, so let us move on to the our next panel, which is about Bharat. Right, am I right, panelist?
Sure.
Okay. So this panel is about serving the underserved. By underserved, we mean people who do not have access to professional financial advice. So they could be your maid, they could be your driver, they could be auto rickshaw driver, and so on and so forth. We have also considered people who belong to B30 cities. So since B30 has 15% contribution in total AUM, so we have a long way to go. So in the two videos, we have seen the first video featured people who have invested in mutual funds, and the second video has featured people who do not have invested in mutual fund. Clearly, people, those who have invested in mutual funds, have been benefited a lot. But the people who do not invested in mutual funds so far want to explore the product. But the actual problem here is no one is there to approach them. So my first question to the panel is that why we have not reached out to them so far? Debashish, would you like to take this?
So your questions happen about we. I will redefine it limited to mutual fund industry, not total financial inclusion. We will talk about AMCs,
yeah,
only.
Only AMCs.
And why we have not reached? Okay, keeping the UTI story aside, I will tell that why we have not reached, because first is we do not have priority to reach. We have not attempted to reach. We do not have incentive to reach. And basically it is not nobody's KRA. That's why nobody has reached it. And it has got few underlining assumptions that when you talk about underserved, sometime we saw one in video of somebody told 18% that he's expecting. At times maybe the unserved is better than underserved. And we also assume that T15 is fully served and the B15 is only remaining unserved or underserved. So people have not reached because they didn't have a visibility of the revenue visibility there. So that's why they have not reached. There are better priorities to reach. There are better clear gathering hunter and gatherers were there, and easy low lying fruits are there. People are eyeing that, and so people have not gone there. So this is the I will tell the demand, the supply side of these things. On the demand side, where the people who do not know, that is ignorance, absolute ignorance. And for them, ignorance is bliss at times. And of course, mutual funds, he has done a great job. And you are going ahead in that direction, and we'll reach one day that. But one was ignorance. Even if ignorance is addressed, the next thing comes inertia. Once we told about one video we have shown, one IAP we have done, we told, thereafter we require continuous pushing or nudge to take him to the next step. And that has not been done. Even if inertia is addressed, the next thing comes is inconvenience. At this point of time, the total ecosystem of our investment, the infrastructure, is fragmented. We have got good payment mechanism. We have got good banking mechanism. We have got good national ID. But all five of things are not talking to each other. It's not a single view. So this inconvenience is also one of the bottleneck why people have not reached. Even that is addressed, this guy will be intimidated to come to an English-speaking office and get his thing done. You're talking about maid and all these things. When I can do it for my daughter, but I couldn't do it for my maid's daughter because she was from a rural area of Maharashtra and she didn't have all those things in place. So these are the things which also demand side also are constraints were there for which people have not yet reached in a great scale.
So Debashish, do you see this as an untapped opportunity, or this is as a social work?
I see it as an untapped opportunity. If you give me time, I'll tell that. First of all, if equity is a good story, or investment in mutual fund is a good story for a person who has got 1 lakh rupees monthly income, it will also be a good story for somebody who has got 10,000 rupees. Only scale will be different. And but I told you that the demand side is not aggregated. The hall full of people, everybody has got 10,000 rupees, their income, maybe 500 rupees they can invest in a month, but it is not visible. But if we can find out a way, a easy logistic, to pipe that to the investment mechanism, then everything will fall in place. And that is actually the trick is that. And CK Prahlad told there is fortune at the bottom of the pyramid. And there is fortune, and this investment will multiply. And only thing, at this point of time, this is difficulties, there are better things to do, and there is revenue is not visible, that's why nobody is attempting.
So JP, my question to you. So humne video mein dekha ki lagbhag har underserved investors ne LIC mein invest kiya hua hai, ya to wo LIC ke bare mein jante hain. But underserved investors na hi unhone mutual fund ke bare mein suna hai, na hi wo mutual fund ke bare mein jante. Aisa kyun?
तो निशान, सबसे पहले तो मैं जैसी महिंद्रा की बात है या हिंदी में आपने प्रश्न कर दिया सुंदर. सो देखिए, लैंग्वेज चेंज हो गई, राइट. सबसे पहले हम क्रेडिट देते हैं LIC को, विच मीन्स एनी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, क्योंकि उन्होंने पिछले 50-70 सालों में जो काम किया है वो हर लेवल तक उन्होंने पेंट्रेशन करने की कोशिश की है. मगर जैसे थोड़ा सा तजबीज जो किया मोहंती जी ने, वो ये था कि प्राइसिंग, अगर मैं सिंपली बोलूँ, प्राइसिंग बहुत डिफरेंट है. ठीक है, हम लोगों की प्राइसिंग रिस्ट्रिक्टेड है. उसके अंदर बिटवीन दी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कम्युनिटी एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, दोनों को उसके अंदर अपने बिजनेस चलाने हैं. एंड इंश्योरेंस के अंदर मे बी लिटिल डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर, एंड कुछ चीज़ें जो अपफ्रंट जो बेनिफिट होते हैं उसके अंदर इंसेंटिव टू ग्रो बिजनेस, टू इन्वेस्ट इन बिजनेस भी ज़्यादा ही रहेगा. सो बट व्हाइल आई से दिस, लेट्स नॉट टेक द क्रेडिट अवे. एंड एट सेम टाइम जस्ट टू एड लिटिल बिट, जो आपका प्रश्न मोहंती जी से था, वाइल्ड वी में से हम अंडर पेनिट्रेटेड, अभी भी हम पूरे सर्व नहीं कर पाएँ. बट अगर आप जर्नी देखोगे, एंड मैं खाली जर्नी इसी सेंचुरी की बात करता हूँ, कि सन 2000 में 1,00,000 करोड़ के एसेट्स थे और आज 25,00,000 करोड़ के एसेट हैं. तो आपकी एवोल्यूशन जो हो रही है उसके अंदर शायद पहले 10 साल और इन 10 सालों में बहुत बड़ी ग्रोथ हुई है. तो हर चीज़ की एक ग्रोथ की एक एस्पेक्ट रहती है. और माय गेस, एक चीज़ जो मिसिंग है, और वो BCG रिपोर्ट जो एम्फी का है उसके अंदर भी आ गया है, कि जो हमने 100 ट्रिलियन रुपीज की बात कर रहे हैं, कि 100,00,000 करोड़ हमने जो आंकड़ा रखा कि 25,00,000 करोड़ से हम वहाँ हमको पहुँचना है, उसके अंदर सबसे बड़ी जो मिसिंग फैक्टर है वो है वो 4,00,000 डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कम्युनिटी जो हमको और करनी है. अगर हम आज एक की बात कर रहे हैं, हमने 4 गुना और उसको करना है खड़ा वहाँ पे. तो अगर आप हमें पूछेंगे, हमारे हिसाब से अगर आंकड़ा कहीं पे गैप है इंश्योरेंस और म्यूचुअल फंड के अंदर, एक समय से वो पूरा हो जाएगा. दूसरा, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के बिना नहीं हो सकता है. हम सब जगह नहीं जा पाएंगे. वी कैन बी फैसिलिटेटर, वी कैन बी ऑन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग लेवल, वी कैन वर्क, बट उस ग्राउंड लेवल के ऊपर इवन FMCG भी, मैं एग्जैक्ट में कंपैरिजन नहीं करना चाह रहा हूँ, वैसे बस समझाने के लिए, FMCG भी जब कोई मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करते हैं तो उनको भी वो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लेकर जाने पड़ती है कंज्यूमर के थ्रू फ्रेंचाइजी. एंड दैट इज वेयर वी आई थिंक ओवर पीरियड टाइम वी विल ओवरकम दैट ऑल्सो.
सो योर कॉन्फिडेंस दैट वी विल एड मोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स?
यस, 100%.
सो सौगाता, माई क्वेश्चन टू यू, इन एम्फीज BCG रिपोर्ट, सो इट हैज रिटन दैट पर कैपिटा डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर इन इंडिया इज़ वेरी लो. इनफैक्ट इट इज़ 1 distributor फॉर एवरी 16,200 पीपल. सो इन B30 द सिचुएशन इज इवन वर्स. सो आई वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वॉट इज़ द रीज़न फॉर दिस ए, एंड बी हाउ वी कैन अट्रैक्ट मोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स इन द अंडर, आई मीन टू सर्विस द अंडरसर्व्ड.
थैंक्स निशांत. दिस एंटायर टॉपिक इज वेरी क्लोज टू आवर AMC's हार्ट. And hence, I'll just quote certain points just to, answer to the question. Firstly, I think इस धंधे में ना passion का बहुत ज़रूरत है. It is all about passion. If one has to go and start serving the underserved or, the community which are maid servants से लेके hawker से लेके panwala and all that community, one has to have passion very, very high, which is both sides. Distributor should have a passion, even the AMC should have the passion to go deeper into this market. unfortunately, that passion is there in limited scope. We have few as panelists. Of course, they had the passion and the vision to get into that space and make it big for them, for the society. I think the passion is very, very important. That's first thing. Second is, how do the existing distributor increase the footprint for all of us? Herein, I would share a very, very important message, and this is what, when I keep traveling across, keep talking to a lot of our partners, is how many of our partners who are already established would like their children or their family members or their friends to come into this profession and then make them go out on the streets and ask money for a 500 rupee SIP or a 1000 rupee SIP from a tea stall owner or a panwala. I think that passion has to, that culture has to be built in our business, and that itself will grow the distribution fraternity to multiple numbers. If we have, we have currently about 75,000 ARN holders in B30 location. Assuming even if 20% of them are working actively and they multiply the workforce within the family or within their own businesses, what they are running, can you imagine what is the sort of ratios? These ratios will become much, much better as we go ahead. But will they be going to that community and asking for that 500 rupees or 2,000 rupees check? I think it's a culture change which we need to get into, because small only will make us big. It is never the case that the reverse happens. The reverse has got various risks attached to it. And there are partners, when I go and meet, I was very happy just last week when I was in some location, that partner tells me that I've opened this office because of that 1,000 rupees SIP, which, or that 500 rupees SIP which I had taken maybe 10 years, 15 years, 20 years back, and I'm still happy to welcome them in my office. So I think that is the culture which we have to start building in our industry. We also are, obviously to start from all of us in the room, and jointly if we can build this culture and that infrastructure can be built, then we did not go and ask for new distributors to come. It is within the fraternity itself the growth can happen. And there is a huge scope for expansion in that space, I think.
So, if 80,000 distributors had 3 members of their family,
it's 2.5 lakhs.
Yeah, we will have 2.5 lakh distributors, and 100 lakh crore AUM is achievable then.
Very true, it is.
So, Debashish, if you like to add something, because you are in the distribution industry, MF industry for so long.
Yeah, I have been talking to these two various forums, and in SEBI also, this IFA and investor SEO. And this clear, very clear proven that if you want to increase the number of investors, first thing you would increase the number of IFA. And for that this profession needs to be sellable, should be sold. And like people are appearing for G and this and that, going to abroad, people should also look forward investment advice as a clean and profitable profession. They should look forward to at the top level, and at every level people will come and join. There will be, of course, layering and different classes, and technology will help them in getting leads. If why can't we innovate like Uberization, like wherever in India somebody has this need that he need to do an SIP, the further step will be taken by one of the IFA, which a central system will prompt, and here somebody wants to do. And so lots of way can be thought of, and so that people's income level also can be little bit up ensured. And one more thing which Reliance, earlier Himanshu and me were talking in Ampi about how to do one tied structure IFA, because now people are not being sure that whether in the absence of upfront they have to incur some expenses, the trail will take time to build up, so how they will sustain in the first 2-3 years. So like every industry has got internship system, so our suggestion to AMFI and SEBI was that you allow us that there will be one limited tied model for first 3 years of the life of a new IFA, which one of the AMC will adopt and teach him various things on technology, how to grow business, how to set up office, how to interact with consumers and services. And these 3 years, some amount of payment will be passed on as fixed and some variable. And at the end of 3 year or 5 year extendable, if you have built a book, this book will be allowed, this guy will take that book and start his business further so that it will be sustainable thereafter. The two things which SEBI objected to this was, one of them was, then if he works with you, then he is limiting his choices to other customer. So it's only, he's selling only one fund house product in the initial days. I told, sir, there are big banks who are selling only their product, their AMC's product. This is nothing new. And this can still be thought of because we are talking of creating a base of new IFA who will be sustainable for initial period of their life. Thereafter, they will stand on their own foot. And the second objection was, while handing over, if you'll be doing on a direct model, how we can hand over the business there. We can start with the distributor regular model and have a dummy code, and that can be handed over to him for starting his book. Exactly what is happening in many security, ICICI direct here and there, people are as an employee leaving the company and doing their own business. So this is a doable model. So if you want to quickly increase the number of IFA training and NISM certification apart, you need sustainability for initial years, then more people will come. Otherwise, people will come, but numbers will be limited. So that one way of talking.
Yeah. I think a lot of points have been covered, but just one direct, if I can put it as a suggestion, we have been putting aside two basis points for investor awareness. So somewhere my thoughts are this, the one goes to AMFI as an industry, one is with the asset management company. The one which goes to the AMFI, 50% of that, which today is a large amount, remember, we are talking about one basis point and half of that which will run into multiple crores, which can be utilized for the industry development in terms of distribution. So while parallelly we are doing all the investor awareness, and if the need of our today is to reach out across India, it cannot happen without distribution. It's never happened for any company, even otherwise. So what I would suggest is part of that fund should be used, because otherwise we are talking about only investor penetration without support coming, and the number that you quoted, 16,000, is a large number. Can that be done? Never. It can't be reached out otherwise. So we need more distribution power, and out here there not be any. If industry is investing, there's no need for AMCs to get involved. We can even outsource this from AMFI level, and the trainers, you know, with a project in hand, they can certainly reach out and make a distribution, take it as education to helping new distributors set up their own businesses as we have done last 15, 20 years.
Okay. So out of two BIPs, one BIP for IAP and one BIP for...
So I'm saying one which goes to AMFI, half of that.
Okay, half of that is for distributors.
Yes,
debit.
Yes. Why not?
That's a great idea.
So that I think work is on. We'll come to the industry forum later on. A couple of things, I think, just to add to the number of distributors growth. And this brilliant idea came from one of our team members when we were discussing. All of us are privy to e-commerce. You know, capital, venture capital is coming and putting money into businesses which are tech-based. Our industry is such a great industry. There is no, startup capital which is coming to, set up this business. If there are new aspirants who want to come into this business, they are going to create wealth for a lot of investors in the future. Why shouldn't startup capitals come and, why can't venture capitals come and put up a startup capital, and then they have entrepreneurs under them who they will groom and make them big businesses? You know, and that is the sort of ideation which we should have, because why should money go into only tech business or the supply chain business? It can come into our business, and our fraternity is doing great for the industry. I think that's a great idea which came up in one of our discussions. And other part, of course, as you touched upon, LIC is doing a great thing for making agents, MDRT aspirants. Why can't we have an MDRT for our industry? Everyone runs their own program, and we try to make partners a CEO club member, XYZ club member. Why can't this industry make aspiration so big that we have an MDRT from our side, and then people come and start talking about us? I think that those are the ideas which we have to really explore at an industry level to create that mass movement to come into our industry.
Coming back to the distributor bhai, so Paresh bhai, aap underserved investors ke sath bahut saalon se aap unko service de rahe hain, right? So hame bataiye ki aapne ye kab shuru kiya aur kyon shuru kiya?
98 mein mera train accident hua tha, uske baad maine business chalu kiya tha. To maine mere friend ko jo maine ek company mein insurance agent ke hisab se launch kiya tha, to usne usi client ne mere ko bola ki aap iske sath joint ho jao. तो मैंने बोला मुझे इंश्योरेंस का बारे में कुछ मालूम नहीं है. तो उसने बोला कि मैं तेरे को सिखा देता हूँ. 6-8 महीना मैंने पोस्ट ऑफिस का किया, फिर उसके बाद पोस्ट ऑफिस और बैंक एफडी किया HDFC लिमिटेड का. तो उधर नीचे कंपनी खुली थी, तो बोला कि ऊपर जाके ऑफिस खुला एक नया, ऊपर जाके फॉर्म भर के आओ. बोलता है किस चीज़ का कंपनी है? बोलता है मालूम नहीं, फॉर्म भर के आ जाओ. तो उधर जाके फॉर्म भर के आया, फिर उसके बाद उधर एक जिगर गांधी करके एक लड़का था, तो उसने मेरे को सिखाया. बोलता है कि ये ऐसा कर ऐसा कर. भाई बोला मुझे म्यूचुअल फंड के बारे में कुछ भी मालूम नहीं है. तो फिर बाद में वो मेरी ऑफिस में आने लगा. उस टाइम पे मेरी ऑफिस तबेले में थी, तो उधर आके रोज बैठता था, थोड़ा बहुत बैठता था, फिर चला जाता था. फिर उसने बोला कि आप ये करते हो ना, तो आपको इसी प्रोडक्ट के बारे में, यही प्रोडक्ट है आपकी, उस खाली नाम बदली हो जाएगा तो चलेगा? हाँ, बोला चलेगा. तो बोला कि क्या है? तो उसने NSE को बताया, टैक्स सेविंग, इक्विटी को बताया, KVP वैसा करके उसने बताया, कंपनी FD को बताया बैलेंस फंड, फिर RD को बताया, SIP को RD बताया. बोलता है उस हिसाब से करते जा तू. बोलते कि वो कैसा कर रहेगा? मैं बोला मुझे इंग्लिश नहीं आता है. बोलते कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, खुद कुछ इंग्लिश में मत बात कर, तू ऐसा क्लाइंट ढूंढ जिसको इंग्लिश नहीं आती है. तो फिर उस टाइम पे मैं बोला कि कितना अमाउंट चलता है इसमें मिनिमम? बोलते तुम जो अमाउंट लेके आएगा वो चलेगा. उस टाइम पे 3,000 रुपया मिनिमम लमसम अमाउंट था, और SIP 200-500 का चलता था उस टाइम पे. तो उसी टाइम पे चलते करते गया. तो एक रिक्शा वाले को सबसे पहले लिया मैंने कि तू एक तू मेरे को ऐसा कर, रोज का 100 रुपया दे, 3 साल में मैं तेरा वर्दी बदली करके दूंगा. वो बोलता है कैसे होगा? मैं बोला तू आज की तारीख में रिक्शा कितने की आती है? 1.5 लाख की. बोलता तू 3 साल तक दे मेरे को बस. तो 3 साल में उस टाइम पर मार्केट अच्छा था, तो उसका पैसा तो अच्छा खासा बढ़ गया. उसने जो पैसा इन्वेस्टमेंट किया था उसी पैसे में रिक्शा आ गई, और उसका जो पैसा जो एक्चुअल अमाउंट था वैसा का वैसा ही था मार्केट में. तो उसने उधर बोर्ड लगा दिया कि गिफ्ट फ्रॉम HDFC ग्रोथ फंड.
अब जो
फिर उसके बाद चाय वाले को पूछा, तो चाय वाले को भी उस हिसाब से किया.
अच्छा, आप जो अंडरसर्व्ड को कैटर कर रहे हैं, तो इज इट प्रॉफिटेबल फॉर यू? आपका कितना बिजनेस आता है अंडरसर्व्ड से?
आज की तारीख में मेरा कम से कम 30-40% का बिजनेस है.
दैट्स अ ग्रेट नंबर. रितेश भाई, आपके पास भी बहुत सारे क्लाइंट्स हैं. यू हैव क्लाइंट्स फ्रॉम मेड्स टू चाय वाला टू इडली वाला टू इवन यू हैव क्लाइंट्स हु आर सेक्स वर्कर्स, राइट? सो हाउ एंड व्हेन हैव यू डिसाइडेड टू कैटर टू दिस अंडरसर्व्ड कैटेगरी?
Thank you, Nishant. Basically, I'm in this industry. I'm actually looks young, but I'm there from last 30 years. Probably, I started when I was in 9.
Is it a Santur thing?
Sorry? So basically, I started when I was in 9th and started with the scratch with helping my dad and mom. They are in this business from 1980. They started with postal, insurance and all that segments. And I was just helping them. And that time there was a PSU, mutual funds, and Unit Trust of India, obviously. So these are the funds which were available, and we used to cater the customers. And what I earned as a knowledge from the situations which has happened in 92 or 2000 was very simple, that if I'm not with my customer, they lose money. And if I'm not helping them, what to do with when this kind of a situation comes? And these are the underserved investors are tempted to equity when there is a hype. And we always say when we speak on some conferences, कि वो पान वाला जब भी बोलेगा कि शेयर में इन्वेस्ट करो, तब तो मतलब वो खुद भी कर ही रहा है ना. तो हम एज एन एडवाइज़र अगर उस टाइम उनके पास जाएं, तो अच्छा होगा. सो आई गॉट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी उस टाइम कि स्मॉल सेविंग्स वालों का एक इंडिया बेसिक ड्राइव था जहाँ पे उन स्टेट्स को पैसा चाहिए था अराउंड हर स्टेट का, महाराष्ट्र का मुझे पता है अराउंड 30,000 करोड़ रुपया टू पाइप वाटर प्रोजेक्ट था मुंबई अपना महाराष्ट्र का. तो उन्होंने स्मॉल सेविंग को प्रमोट करने के लिए कलेक्टरों को परमिशन दी थी कि आप जो भी चाहे बूस्ट कीजिए बट धंधा लाइए, और ये पैसा स्टेट यूज़ करती है नॉर्मली जो स्मॉल सेविंग्स में आता था. सो उस टाइम पे मुझे मौका मिला, मेरे फैमिली में यंग हूँ और घर में सब बिजी हैं, मॉम डैड अपना स्मॉल सेविंग का और पोस्ट ऑफिस अपना म्यूचुअल फंड्स का और इंश्योरेंस का बिजनेस में, सो क्या करना चाहिए. तो मुझे असाइन किया गया कि भाई ये काम तो ऑब्लिगेशन में करना है तो बेटा कर ले. एंड आई वॉज देयर, आई वॉज विद देम एंड आई वॉज अलाउड टू गो ईच एंड एवरी सेगमेंट ऑफ क्राउड लाइक पुलिस ऑफिस, पुलिस कमिश्नर ऑफिस और पुलिस स्टेशन टू आर्मी और नेवी और एयरफोर्स, हूएवर इज देयर इन मुंबई बाउंड्री. सो फ्रॉम कुलाबा टू दहीसर, द वन ऑफ द बेस्ट थिंग वॉट आई लर्न और आई स्विच टू दिस सेगमेंट वॉज म्यूनसिपल ऑफिस where I was approached by the health officers, and I used to go with them to the slums where they go for the medical wo jo tika bolte na tika dene jo medical officers jate hain unke sath mein jata tha. और उस टाइम पे मुझे किसी ने बताया कि सर आप क्यों नहीं ये कम्युनिटी को जमा करके कुछ इन्वेस्टमेंट के बारे में बता दो. तो आज जिसे हम इन्वेस्टमेंट अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम बोलते हैं वो टाइम पे अनऑफिशियली हम इस तरह से रन करते थे, 20-25 लोग मिल गए, हम उनको इन्वेस्टमेंट के बारे में बताते थे. और वो जब कस्टमर लोग इन्वेस्ट करना चालू किया और उनका पैसा थोड़ा बढ़ा, और जो मेरे माँ बाप मेरे वजह से बताते कि भाई पैसा जब लोगों का बढ़ के मिलेगा और वो देख के तुम्हें जो खुशी होगी वो पैसा नहीं कमा पाएगा. एंड वो उस दिन था और मेरा स्विच होना कि भाई ये इंडस्ट्री को, ये सेगमेंट को मुझे हेल्प करना चाहिए. एंड आज तक अराउंड मैं 30,000 से 40,000 फैमिलीज़ को मिल चुका हूँ मुंबई में ही, बट हर एक को मैं सर्व नहीं कर सकता हूँ, बट या आई एम ट्राइंग माई बेस्ट टू हेल्प देम.
परेश भाई, जब मैं आपसे लास्ट टाइम मिला था तो आपने बताया था कि आप कैसे अंडर सर्विस्ड इन्वेस्टर्स के पास को अप्रोच करते हैं, तो क्या आप हम सबके साथ शेयर करना चाहेंगे प्लीज़? वो चाय वाले का आपने
सबसे पहला तो चाय वाले को मैंने उसके पास, जो मेरी ऑफिस का चाय वाला है तो उसके पास जा डेली मॉर्निंग में मैं पीता हूँ चाय, तो उसके पास पूरा हिस्ट्री जान लिया उसका, उसके घर में कौन कौन है, उसके गाँव में क्या खेती बाड़ी है, कौन रहता है, उसका बच्चा बच्चे लोग क्या करते हैं, तो उस हिसाब से उसको समझाता हूँ. फिर बाद में दोस्ती में उसको पूछा मैंने कि दिन में कितनी चाय बेचता है तू, तो बोलता है 800,000 रुपया, 800,000 कप चाय बेचता हूँ कटिंग. फिर बोला मैंने कॉफ़ी कितनी बेचता है, बोलता है 100-150 कॉफ़ी बिकती है. फिर पूछा कि कुकाड़ा कितना बेचता है, तो बोलता है 50 तक जाता है. मैं बोला ठीक है, अगर कोई आदमी तेरे को 6 रुपये की कटिंग का तेरे को 5.5 रुपया देगा तो क्या करेगा तू? बोलता है चुपचाप ले लेगा और क्या करेगा. मैं बोला दूसरा आदमी आया, दिन में 10 आदमी आएंगे तेरे पास, 8-8 आना तेरे को कम देगा तो क्या करेगा तू? बोलता है कुछ नहीं. तो मैं बोला तो 8 आना तू मेरे को देगा क्या? बोलता है क्या होगा 8 आने में, ये लो. मैं बोला वैसा नहीं चाहिए 8 आना, मेरे को हर एक कटिंग का 8 आना दे तू मेरे को, तो मैं तेरे लड़के को SSC के बाद से लेके 15वीं तक मैं उसको पढ़ाऊँगा, तो चलेगा क्या? बोलते अच्छा है ना, तो फिर बोलता है तो रोज़ लोगे पैसा मेरे से. मैं बोला मैं तो रोज़ चाहिए मेरे को, लेकिन रोज का रोज रोकड़ा नहीं लूँगा मैं, तेरे को एक स्लिप बुक बना एक बैंक में अकाउंट खोल के देता हूँ, भारत कोऑपरेटिव बैंक में मैंने अकाउंट खोल के दिया उसको. तो उसको बोला कि ये जगह पर तेरा नाम लिखने का, इधर तेरा अकाउंट नंबर लिखने का, इधर अमाउंट लिखने का, हर तेरे को दूसरे दिन उधर जाके भरने का है. और मैं बोला कि कंपनी वाला भी तेरे से रोज़ नहीं लेगा, क्योंकि रोज तेरे अकाउंट में से पैसा निकलेगा तो तू कम बैंक वाला तेरे को चीटर समझेंगे, तो तू क्या कर. मैं क्या करता हूँ तेरे लिए कि हर महीने की 1 तारीख को, 5 तारीख को, 7 तारीख को, 10 तारीख को, 20 तारीख को, 25 तारीख को, ऐसा 6-7 दिन में तेरे पास से अलग अलग लूँगा. तो बोला ठीक है, तो उसने चालू कर दिया. स्टार्टिंग में मैंने उसको बोला था कि तेरा 2-3 हज़ार का SIP करते, तो बोलता है नहीं म्यूचुअल फंड में नहीं डालने का पैसा. क्यों नहीं? बोलो किधर क्या करते कुछ मालूम नहीं है. ठीक है तुम लेकिन मेरे बच्चे को पढ़ाओगे ना? मैं बोला हाँ बच्चे को पढ़ाऊंगा भी
और साथ में तेरे एक बच्चे की शादी भी करवाऊंगा फ्री में. फिर उसको बोला कि तेरा कॉफ़ी का क्या करता है, अभी तेरे बच्चे लोग तो पढ़ाई कर लेंगे तो बाद में तेरे धंधे में तो आने ही वाले नहीं है. तो बोलता है तो क्या है, मैं बोला कॉफ़ी का 1 रुपया दे दे. बोलता है क्या करेगा कॉफ़ी 1 रुपया का. मैं बोला तू जिस दिन तू बड़ा हो जाएगा, समझ ले तेरे पिताजी की उम्र का, उस दिन तेरे को 1 कॉफ़ी का 1 रुपये की जगह पर मैं 1 कॉफ़ी का 10 रुपया दूंगा. तू रोज का 100 कॉफ़ी का 100 रुपया देता है मेरे को, तो उसके बदले में तेरे को 1000 रुपया दूंगा रोज का. उस हिसाब से मैं उन लोग को बेचता हूँ.
रितेश, आप बहुत टाइम से IPs कर रहे हैं इस फिल्म्स में जाके, सो व्हाट आर द 3 थिंग्स दैट अंडरसर्व्ड इन्वेस्टर्स एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम अ फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट?
फर्स्ट इज दे लुक एट सेफ्टी, सेकंड दे लुक एट कमिटमेंट इन द सेंस दे वांट अस देयर, दे वांट अस अवेलेबल एट द टाइम्स व्हेन दे रियली वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड और नीड मनी. And third one is when you are committing something, so they need somebody. They don't understand products. They understand you. They understand your commitments. So on that commitment, they need something which they get it back. So very simple and easy they are. Just you need to be there with them to understand. And that's the key, I believe, out of this. And as well, if you want me, if you permit me to, I can ask question to my friends here, that how many of us as an advisors really do such investors investments? Maybe some of us do it for your mates, do it for your the watchmen. That's all, that's what we do. Out of your gate we don't go. हम बोलते हैं हम भी कर रहे हैं अंडरसर्व को सर्व, बट वो बिल्डिंग तक सीमित हो जाता है और हम उसके बाहर नहीं गए. जो अगर हम वहाँ तक जाएं, बहुत अच्छे प्यारी जनता है और बहुत प्यारे लोग हैं, सिर्फ उनसे कनेक्ट करो एंड वो अपनी, मतलब जैसे बोलते हैं ना कि जान भी दे देंगे, उस तरह का फीलिंग है और वो सही में करते हैं. कुछ हमें ज़रूरत पड़ी वो रहते हैं खड़े, जब हम उनके साथ खड़े रहें तो वो रिस्पेक्ट भी करते हैं. बहुत सारे इंसिडेंट है जहाँ पे जो रिस्पेक्ट है वो कोई पैसा नहीं कमा सकता. पैसा नेचुरली आप उनको कमिटेड हो, उनको खुश रख पाए हो तो पैसा आता है और आई थिंक इनफ है. ऐसा कोई कमी नहीं पड़ता है लाइफ में कि कुछ कम आ गया. जैसे लोग मुझे, मेरे फ्रेंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स बहुत सारे मिलते हैं, बात होती है, बोलते रितेश भाई ये 500,000 रुपये में मिल मिला के मिलता क्या है और ये मुझे नहीं जमता है. या कोई बोल देता है कि भाई ठीक है ये मुझसे नहीं होता है. मैं उन्हें बोलता हूँ कि भाई ठीक है, आज तुम्हारा खर्च बार का 50 रुपया 100 रुपया अगर SIP 1000 की कर लो तो होता है. आप देखोगे अगर लॉन्ग टर्म 5 साल वो बंदा पैसा मांगता नहीं है, उसे अगर ज़रूरत पड़ी तो ही आएगा आपके पास, अदरवाइज तो भूल जाता है. जैसे मेरे पास फोलियोज है 90s से है, आज कंपनी के नाम चेंज हो गए. जैसे कैलाश सर ने पहले फॉरम में बताया कि मेरा खुद का एक फोलियो है, उसी तरह से लोगों के मेरे पास तो बहुत सारे फोलियोज़ है. और जो अभी हमारे KYC मैंडेट वाली जो प्रोसेस हुई उसके अंदर इट वाज अ बिग स्ट्रेस फॉर मी. ऑनेस्टली इट वाज अराउंड लॉन्ग बिग नंबर, बट या थैंक्स टू माई इंडस्ट्री फ्रेंड्स हु हैव हेल्प मी टू गेट इट सॉल्व. मगर या ये कैटेगरी को सर्व करने के लिए थोड़ा माइंडसेट अलग चाहिए और सक्सेस, जैसे मैं शायद थोड़ा दूसरी जगह चले गया था, बट या आई एम अटैच्ड टू, सो सॉरी आई एम जस्ट टेकन इट टू सम अदर लेवल, सॉरी.
ओके, सो देबाशीष, UTI MF हैज वर्क विद मेनी NGOs लाइक सेवा टू रीच आउट टू द अंडरसर्व्ड. सो टेल अस हाउ, व्हाट वाज द रैशनल एंड हाउ हैज बीन द रिस्पॉन्स सो फार?
सी, दैट वाज द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल the unit trust of India, the original UTI, when it was conceived and created in the Act of Parliament, that was the main objective, to democratize the access to capital market for the common man so that they can take part in the prosperity potential. But when new UTI was there, it was year 2006, and Mr. UK Sinha was our head. So that time, what we can do for this segment, with this thought came. That particular time NPS citizen was not there, and there were the calculations and estimation that around 89% of the people of workers population of India was not having any retirement solutions, no income securities and old age. And so we have a plan for retirement plan. Now many other fund houses have that. So we try to find out who can be a homogeneous group where it can be promoted. Ahmedabad has got a self-employed women's association. They are head loaders, vegetable vendors, agarbati rollers, BD rollers, and stitch workers. So they are the people who are very, very, they could spare 35 rupees per month investment, that sort of segment. And we started with 50,000 such women because challenges are there everywhere, difficulties are there. We have to find out solutions that bank volunteered to collect, pull the account and give us money. Technology was used. We did door-to-door campaign. Thereafter, multi-level of doubt clearances, how not to mis-sell. All these things happened. And from that day onward, we gathered more momentum, maybe more than 1 million such people we could get. And one of the challenge I can tell you right now was how to get cash, money. And we got a segment where they didn't have even cash. They have milk. They are milk federation farmers. So we found a formula, dud do, pension low. He can give 1 liter of additional milk to his milk federation in the block level, block gave to district level, district gave to the state level, and state gives him money back once in a month. So he collects more milk, gives us that additional milk equivalent of money value to us in his retirement scheme plan, and that's how we got the SEBI approval for collecting from the organization for the individual, and his accounts are activated. No persistency problem, continuously this money is coming, and we created AMFI certified distributors there in the, among the community to which go around and talk and get those accounts. This was done, 35,000 such people are still continuing with us. So different groups. It could be the Mandesi Grameen Bank, when all women, four women there in the Satara, that account came. Like that, if there is a will, the way will come. And we have to involve various advisor community, distributor community. Somewhere it's a bank, somewhere it's a trust, somewhere individuals. And that's how this could be successful.
Saugata, your fund house has recently launched lump sum investment of rupees 100 in mutual fund. So what was the rationale and how are you going to popularize it?
Yeah, so again extending from what Debashish was saying, the biggest hurdle, and which Paresh bhai also was mentioning, is the amount. What is happening, see, we segmented. We try to understand which segment of the investor community is now likely to come into the mutual funds more often now because of the campaign, etc. So we kept on seeing that there is a strong will of the young population to start, they wanted to come into mutual funds. We have seen the popularity of PTM, etc. So to ensure that the younger guys, they come in, they start with a small amount, and then they start getting into the habit of saving and investing through MF. We said that let's bring down the threshold from 500 to 100 rupees. I think this is a very important step for us because we believe, again, like popular, we have been able to popularize mutual funds in the past. Going into the younger segment and bringing them in is very important. Just to give a small parlance to how the mobile operators, created this big impact. Chota Recharge, we have all heard about that. The success story of Chota Recharge was go in bits and pieces and keep recharging your SIM card, and you start getting used to that particular provider. Similarly, if we keep giving in bits and pieces, which is in smaller amount, the investor or the younger guys, they start getting used to the phenomena of saving or investing through MF. And it has started now giving us good dividends. The number of applications which are coming are high. Yes, the cost factor is a challenge. We'll have to see how we go about it. But though it is early days, we are very, very confident that the 100 rupee investor will migrate to 2,000, 3,000, and then we start off, settle down on an average cost of investment which comes from these investors. That was our thought process.
JP, आपके fund house का focus rural segment है. So, क्या आप बता सकते हैं कि आप कैसे उन तक पहुंच रहे हैं?
निशांत जी, रूरल की बात कर रहे हैं, मैं पहले क्लैरिफाई कर दूं, बहुत लोग कंफ्यूज कर जाते हैं. हमारा बिजनेस अर्बन एंड पैरेलल, हमारी उसकी कंसंट्रेशन मध्यम वर्गीय जो अपने शहर हैं और गांव हर तरफ है. चैलेंज जो मैंने पहले शुरू में कहा, इट्स अबाउट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, क्योंकि जब हमने शुरू किया वी फाउंडेड वेरी वी इवन ट्राइड इंटरनली वी फाउंडेड वेरी सून दैट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के ऊपर हमको काफ़ी काम करना पड़ेगा. मगर एट द सेम टाइम व्हाट वी डिडंट वांट टू डू, वी आर वेरी क्लियर, प्रायोरिटी है. तो ऐसा नहीं होगा कि पहले बॉम्बे आएगा, फिर पुणे आएगा, फिर कोल्हापुर आएगा, फिर हम सांगली जाएंगे. वी सेड वी आर गोइंग टू इन्वेस्ट इन बिजनेस पैरेलली. तो द नेक्स्ट स्टेज विल नॉट वेट कि मैं 5-7 सालों के बाद वहाँ पर जाऊँगा. सो इन्वेस्टमेंट्स हैव ऑलरेडी बीन डन अक्रॉस इंडिया. नाउ टू टेल यू व्हाट द सम ऑफ द मिसिंग पीसेस मे जस्ट बी लिटिल बिट मोर अवेयरनेस एंड माई गेस लास्ट लेवल ऑफ हैंड होल्डिंग, क्योंकि अपॉर्चुनिटी है. क्योंकि जब और हम जनरली जो मैं कहने जा रहा हूँ ये एप्लीकेबल सिर्फ सेमी रूरल के लिए नहीं है, ये अर्बन के लिए भी है. हाउ डू वी थिंक दैट विथ ऑलमोस्ट 2 crore यूनिक फोलियोज वी आर डन अ बिजनेस, राइट? वेन एमफी इज टॉकिंग अबाउट, बीसीजी रिपोर्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट 10 crore, राइट? वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट नेक्स्ट 4 times बिजनेस ग्रोइंग, इट विल नॉट हैपन विदाउट both sides contributing. And if you go and read the report, the B15 and B30, right? So when we set up the business 3-3.5 years back, people used to call us, you are crazy, right? There are 5-7 years nobody has set up a business, and now you are coming up setting up a business, and suddenly after demonetization, when the market has gone up 50% in terms of our total AUM, people are saying it was a good decision. So every decision in hindsight can be justified. But we are saying we are gone parallel already, and you will see that in next 5-10 years, when we are talking about $3-10 trillion industry, the business that we are in, right, the savings converted into investment is a balance, becomes a balance sheet item. If you think about compounding, I'm not talking about compounding performance only, I'm talking about compounding of business. It is a huge number. I will not be surprised if that 100 trillion rupees is broken before what we are projecting. Right? Because my guess, nobody would have thought 3 years back that from 16, 17 lakh crore, we go to 25 lakh crore so soon. So you will have a burst of consolidation, and you will have a time when you will have a great big jump, leap also. And my guess, we are going through both in the last 5 years. So the reach out will happen. There's a huge prosperity that is happening in front of us. The only thing is, happen so slowly that when build-up happens and people become prosperous, we think we should have done that. And we didn't want to wait for that. We are investing. It's just a beginning. And since it's in our DNA, I think it will continue on investing on it.
Okay. So one last question to all the panelists. So I would need a small response because we are running out of time. So investing 3,000 a month is a challenge for underserved. But they can invest 100 rupees each day. But do we have any mechanism to collect that 100 rupees?
Yeah, so that is the challenge which Debashish also mentioned. So we are working on that. How do we get the technology interface along with the the bank account? I think MFU is a industry body. We'll have to talk with MFU. How they can facilitate this entire process. I'm sure there are some solutions will come. Because it's a great, great social service which we will be doing to get the smaller investors into the mutual funds. But cost is a very important factor. So that's one challenge which we'll definitely break as we go ahead. And that will scale up the numbers from here on.
It's entirely doable. Its amount, our system will calculate decimal points. One of the payment bank and fintech company, not taking the name, they have already enabled and tested and done it. 1 rupee gold you can buy now, and after 1 second you can sell that 1 rupee gold. And if AMCs can make it happen that 100 rupees is okay. See, cost can be, technology is the actually, if you can commoditize the technology and the it will cost will come down. But this 100 rupees will work and doable.
I would not like to be over obsessed with the 100 rupee, right? So even if it is 500, and sometimes I feel that a person who can invest more, we should not bring the number down. If you, right? So maybe it can be 500 weekly, we can give the other solutions which are already present. But my guess, where I agree with everyone on the panel, the last mile effort is required, which starts from simplification. Because today, let's say the KYC process, right? So as soon as the common KYC of the financial world, we can make it common. Instead of today, we have done it common for the mutual fund, for the whole financial, whether you have done insurance or you have done a banking account, for example, Jan Dhan, right? 35, 40 crore Jan Dhan accounts are there, and then we have other accounts. So if we can commonize that part, I think a lot of the problems will solve. It will become simple. And my guess, Debashish and Chatty are right one way, because the 100 rupee automatically then can become reality. But why not go for 500 and 1,000 if we can say that you can accumulate and do 500 on a weekly basis instead of 100 on a daily basis? Because otherwise, to be frank, the cost implications are very heavy for that. And sometimes, you know, when we run a business, we have to be careful about that also.
So Paresh, 100 rupees?
100 rupees mein koi problem nahi. Agar aap ek jagah se 100 rupees lete ho na, haan, तो आपको उसके आजू बाजू वाले के साथ में कम से कम 5 से 7 एप्लीकेशन और आ जाती है. गारंटी के साथ बोलता हूँ, यहाँ पर किसी ने भी अपने चाय वाले का SIP नहीं लिया होगा. जो आदमी किधर भी खर्चा करता है तो वो सामने वाला आदमी कमाता ही है, तो उसका मतलब वो कमाता है तो उसको इन्वेस्टमेंट करने का हक है. तो वो हक क्यों हम लोग छीनते हैं? उसको सामने से बताओ ना कि मैं ये धंधा करता हूँ. हम लोग तो सबसे पहला डरते हैं कि मैं म्यूचुअल फंड का धंधा करता हूँ. और हर एक IFA का मैंने देखा है, 5 लाख का चेक लेने का है तो पहला भागेगा, लेकिन 500 रुपये का है तो कोई नहीं भागेगा. लेकिन 500 रुपये का वाला जब बोलता है ना कि हाँ ये मेरा इतना रुपया बन गया, तो साथ में दूसरा 10 आदमी को बोलता है कि भाई मेरा भी कर ले. चकाला में सिगरेट फैक्ट्री है, वहाँ पर लाइन से मेरे को बुलाते थे, भाई मेरे घर से भी लेके जाना करके. एक दिन में मैंने 25 एप्लीकेशन कलेक्ट किया था.
रितेश, फाइनल.
एक्चुअली आई एम डूइंग इट एंड यू आर अ विटनेस टू दैट प्रोसेस. सो नॉर्मली आई हैव ओपन अ पोस्टल सेविंग्स अकाउंट एंड इशूड अ चेकबुक टू हिम एंड थ्रू विच आई एम मेकिंग देम इन्वेस्ट एवरी डे. वट एवर मनी आई कलेक्ट एवरी डे, पर्सनली आई गो टू पोस्ट ऑफिस एंड डिपॉजिट. And on a monthly basis, the SIP goes from that account. So anyways, I'm doing it. I don't know the cost. I'm doing it.
Thank you. Thank you so much, panelists.